Hello, crafty peeps. It's Cheyenne from pixiecrafter.com. I'm an independent Stampin' Up! Demonstrator. If you're looking for a demonstrator, I would love for you to choose me. You can shop my online store 24/7, or maybe you're looking to become a Stampin' Up! Demonstrator. Go ahead and contact me. I would love to have you join my team. We're a very positive, fun group. You can be a pixie crafter. All right, welcome to Scrapbook Saturday. This is so much fun. I took a break last week from it. We made the Shrinky Dink plastic charms, and that was a good time. But now it's time to get back into scrapbooking. So I've pulled together a few things, and you know how it is. I do process videos, so I'll probably end up adding more to this initial supplies. So we'll see. Alright, so right now, this is the photo that I'm scrapbooking. This is my kiddo many years ago, and we are sitting out on Grandma and Papa's porch next door, and Ethan's got one of those little smoothies there that you just add the juice to and you shake up, and he loved these. He loves his smoothie. This boy and smoothies go way back, and it's a match made in heaven. So just a fun little picture of him drinking that in the summer, enjoying the summer. And look at how white my boy's legs are. He is a white boy. That's okay, because so is his mama and his daddy. All right, so we've got some very vanilla 12 by 12 cardstock. This is going to be our base. We're going to be doing some fun stuff with this. I pulled out some Tempting Turquoise because I love how it kind of brings out this little blue here, so it kind of pops the photo a little bit more. And then we've got some very vanilla, no, not very vanilla, this is Whisper White, so that's going to be fun to use. I've got Basic Black Archival Ink. We're going to be using our Diagonal Stripe background. I've also got my embossing paste and the brick from the Pattern Party Decorative Masks set, and I've got some of the metallic enamel shapes that I want to add on there too. So, all right, let's get started. All right, now that I've got that basic mat taken care of and trimmed out, let's go over what we're going to be doing with the embossing paste. So I've got my 12 by 12 very vanilla and the mask. Now I'm going to use a little bit of masking tape to make sure that this isn't going to squiggle around too much. Now I'm planning on kind of having this maybe here and kind of having things kind of go this way with it. So I want this to be very organic. I'm not going to fill in all of this. I'm just going to pop on just a little bit of dimension here and there. So we're just going to just get that going just like that, just a wee bit. Nothing too crazy. I'm going to ink over this a little bit. Alright, now let's get this moved over more to here. Alright, so there we go. Got that all inked up. A couple places I want to go ahead and flick off before it's completely dry. Didn't quite get everything, but it's okay because I want it to be kind of flowy. So remember to go ahead and wash your mask as soon as possible. Don't let it dry on this because then you're going to be crying. Now let's get back to the process. Thank you. Okay, here is the finished scrapbook layout. It was a little bit of a process, and this is not quite what I had in mind when I initially envisioned it, but that's what I find kind of happens as I'm doing my layouts. I have a general idea, and then it kind of takes on a life of its own, and it morphs into what it wants to be. So I'm loving this. I think it would be perfect as a base for any sort of summer holiday sort of theme. So like July 4th, the Memorial Day, or Veterans Day, any of those, any like U.S. patriotic theme, I think this works for. Especially if you had just kept it, like I started to distress it. If you didn't distress it with just like the red and the tempting turquoise, I mean, that was just gorgeous all on its own. So I was very like, oh, hey, it looks like a bomb pop. So that was fun. But I love the diagonal stripe background stamp that gave me the fun diagonal stripe paper. I love me a black and white stripe. Well, I love me a stripe no matter what, really, especially if it's diagonal. I love this texture that the embossing paste gave. Let's see, what else? I've got some timeless textures to just kind of like distress and kind of blend up around the corners. I made my own spritzers from my ink refills and isopropyl alcohol in my little spritz bottles. So yeah, that was fun. I'm very happy with how this turned out. Let me know if there's any part of this that you want me to do a more in-depth tutorial on. All right, that is it. So thank you so much for watching. If you liked what you saw, please remember to like and subscribe. Feel free to leave me any comments. What was your favorite part about this? Are you going to want to try out the embossing paste for yourself? There's still some more experiments I have to do with this embossing paste. I love it, love it. All right, remember you can shop my online store 24/7 and a full list of the products I use can be found in the description bar below, along with links to my online store. There's also a link to pixiecrafter.com. You can head on over there for more project ideas and inspirations. You can also sign up for my monthly newsletter. And if you're a resident of the US, you can sign up for my birthday club. You can follow me on Facebook and Instagram. And remember, you can always join my team of pink crafters and become a demonstrator yourself. All right, that's it for today. Until next time, happy crafting.